Okay, well, this is an update on this video. So what's happened is I've tried to replace the fuel filter about 3 or 4 years later. I'd say maybe 3 years. I replace it every year, but this car's been in storage and it's a bit complicated. Okay, so I assembled it, I replaced it, I started it up, and I had a leak at the bottom of the fuel filter here. So this time, this is a rubber gasket. I'm going to push that into place, and I'm going to use that. I didn't have Teflon on the bottom thread, so that's there. So the Teflon is now in place there. On the top, I've got the fuel pressure gauge, and I've got Teflon on that. And so it's just those things that that needed to be done. So with the fuel pressure gauge, you use a spanner to wind it on. You've got the nut underneath the fuel gauge. Okay, so I'm not very happy with that rubber gasket there. That's on the underneath. That's the top there. It's actually buckled, and I can't get it to sit in place, so that'll be coming out. Okay, so we'll put there's the holder there, the bracket. So it just goes up through there. Just have to make sure you clear the. I'll just realign that. So there's the fuel. Just have to work around that. So I'm just going to just put it on pause. Just a reminder that when you do use Teflon on threads, when you disassemble, just make sure that you scrape all of the Teflon out. You can use one of these types of tools. It's a metallic pick. You can use a wooden pick if you want. Okay, so I have threaded the inlet, no, the outlet to the engine underneath the filter. I've put that in. I've made sure the Teflon is sitting right. Now I've got these two washers here. One has to go underneath. It's better that these are new. Don't drop them. So one goes there. I'll put the other one here. This is an adapter I've made and an extension so I can fit a fuel pressure gauge. I think I got this on Amazon. So I'm just going to try to put this through while I'm videoing. It's not going through the bottom washer. Okay, I'll just salvage that. Okay, there it is there. So I'll just give that a clean. And try to situate that underneath. It's not easy. In fact, I can just lift this up, put it on, sit it back down, and just double check it's on there. And it is. And I'll just thread that on. This time I am using the thinner Teflon. So that's the stuff I was using. It's a little bit thicker. I'm using the thinner, so it should wind up in the threads a bit more. But you do, of course, have to put more, you have to go around more around the thread with the thinner Teflon. Just a tip, if you center, you've got two areas, two threads where you can put two screws here. If you center your spanner directly over the top, then you can do the bottom nut up as well as undo it. So that makes things easier. Okay, so we're going to do up the top nut. For my extension and the banjo bolt there, I do have an extension. You may not need that if yours is stock standard. So we've got our spanner here holding the bottom of the filter. So it should stay in place. See how that goes. Okay, well, unfortunately, my banjo bolt adapter has snapped at the hole there where the fuel goes through. So I'll be waiting for another one of them. I'll order one and then I'll go on with it then. Okay, well, fortunately, I was able to relocate these adapters. So that's it there. That's the information. So I've got two this time, so next time I can just continue on with my work. So that's all of it there. It comes with this sideways adaption. So I remove that and I've got this extension that goes in. And then my fuel pressure gauge gets screwed into the extension adapter. One interesting observation is the size of the hole. So it looks as if it could be big enough, but it doesn't look as if it's as big as the original from about 3 years ago. They did luckily come with these new washers. I like to use new washers. So let's assemble it all. Okay, I get it now. So the reason that this hole is that size is because these have been returned and there's been complaints because of the banjo bolt snapping. So for strength for this area here, they've made this as small as they can, see. So that's about as small as they can make it while the engine will still run and still perform. That's my guess. Let's find out. But anyway, the adapter is installed. I haven't done it up too much because this is a bit porous, this metal. So let's go with something like that. Put that other washer there and hope that it doesn't go on an expedition anywhere. It's not really going my way. Okay, that's a bit more confidence inspiring. Okay. As I tighten it, I'll have to make sure that this stays over on that point there. The lock-in metal tabs on either side do strike it up to halfway, which is about as tall as they need to be up on either side. So let's try and get a torque wrench onto it. Okay, we're going to go with 50 foot-pounds. So this will be 50 foot-pounds. I did get an extra bit of a turn out of it after it resting for a bit. I'll try it again. Okay, that seems to have settled on 50 foot-pounds, which should be enough. Okay, just pointing out that this it's stopping from turning by using this spanner here. Okay, I've got Teflon on the on the thread of the fuel pressure gauge. And of course, we're assuming that all of these threads are correct and that I've ordered the right one. I'm pretty sure I have ordered the right one. So once it gets to about with that pressure there, Teflon is now entering the thread to seal it. And I'm going to use a 11 millimeter open end spanner to turn it in. Okay, it's starting to get there now. Don't want to put too much pressure on it, so I think I'm just going to turn it to that point there. I don't think it needs any more, so that should do. I'd just like to point out also that my battery is covered, and also the negative is disconnected. I may have pointed that out previously in the video. I can't remember because this is 2 or 3 weeks later. Okay, well, I have to reassemble to start the motor to do a visual test as to whether fuel's leaking. So I'll reassemble and start it up, and then we'll know. So now with the engine running for about 10-15 minutes, we can see there's no leaks. So there's no leaks from there. And underneath the car, okay, so thanks for watching. It didn't go all that smoothly, I know, but I film it all, the complications and the jobs that go along smoothly. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe.